A quick glance at the distribution of active volcanoes above sea level immediately shows that their locations are not randomly distributed over the globe. They are highly concentrated along linear to arcuate bands, particularly adjacent to the edges of continents. Most of the rest of the active volcanoes are found on the sea floor in similar linear to arcuate bands. These bands mark the edges of the tectonic plates. Volcanism is common at both divergent and convergent plate boundaries, with magma being generated in large quantities at both locations. At divergent boundaries, magma is generated primarily by decompression melting of already hot rocks at shallow depths along mid-ocean ridges. At convergent boundaries, melting is produced primarily by temperature increases in water-rich rocks as they descend into the mantle at the subduction zone. While the location of most of Earth's active volcanoes outlines major plate boundaries, hotspot volcanoes in the interior of the plates allow us to track the direction and speed of plate motions over time. Hotspots appear to be the result of rising plumes of hot material from deep within the mantle, probably originating at the core mantle boundary. As magma bodies from hotspots periodically puncture the surface, volcanoes are produced, which are then carried away from the hotspot by the plate motions. By dividing the distance of an old volcano from the active hotspot by the age of the volcano, the average speed of plate motion over that time can be determined. The direction of plate motion can then be deduced by the orientation of the resulting chain of volcanoes tracing back to the active hotspot. Examples include the Hawaii Emperor chain in the Pacific and the string of calderas running from southeast Oregon to Yellowstone in northwest Wyoming. Understanding the location and type of plate boundaries and the volcanoes that mark them make it possible to better assess the potential hazards to human life and property that future eruptions may represent. By mapping out the types and ages of eruptions, the time frame and size of the eruptive hazards can be evaluated. The ages and positions of volcanoes in the western U.S. show that, aside from the hotspot in Hawaii, volcanic activity has been confined almost entirely to the West Coast and Alaska over the past million years. Indeed, all but one eruption in the past 300 years occurred either in Hawaii or along the convergent boundary running from Northern California to the end of the Aleutian Island chain.